have to say that looking back at the 2 years that have gone into following the Messiah, I think of the thousands and thousands of hours that this team has put into it, that you guys have put into it, that Jeremy, Barry, Craig, Dan, the boys have all put into it, and it's just the beginning. And that's what's really cool. And you know, we can't do this without our donors. I know early on, Craig and I made the decision that we wanted to give away a lot of these series for free. And you know, a lot of people might say, well, that's crazy. And we believed that the Gospels were something that should be accessible to everybody. Through the power of donations, we've been able to do this, and the thousands of hours that this team has put into it.
You think about the reason why. Why would you want to be a part of this? And why was I excited to go back again, right? Because I could have said, no, you know, that was a lot to take on. The moment we got back last year, there was no hesitation on should we finish this or right. could I or should I finish it? Like, I want to go back now. The whole point is to bring these places to life. I mean, when you think about what Appian Media has set out to do, and it doesn't end with following the Messiah.
Right.
The Bible is so rich, and it's all true, not just the story of Jesus. And the story of Jesus doesn't start with his birth either. Mm-hmm. The whole Bible points to Jesus.
People might wonder, this is a lot. I mean, we mentioned during production year 2017, my family was moving, your family was moving, this adoption process got going for me, Stu's son was born just before the trip. I mean, it's a lot. And then we disappear for 2 weeks, and it's not just 2 weeks of production, it's weeks and months of work and post-production and writing and organizing and fundraising. And why do all of that? Why go back?
Well, the first time Craig called me 2 years ago and asked me about this, he spoke for like 10 minutes or so without even stopping. He was so excited about it. When he stopped, I had two responses. One was, however I can help, I'm in. But the second thing was, I think what you'll learn is that there's not just 5 or 10 stories to tell. There's 500 stories to tell. So many beautiful, beautiful stories in the Bible about the salvation God has always planned for his people. We want to find ways of telling as many people as we can about it.
It's easy, especially during the period after our trip, where we're not in Israel, we're not on that high. There's hard, long work involved where, you know, why are we doing this? And then you get a comment like this on YouTube where a complete stranger said, thank you for these. I found these during a really dark time in my life, and it really showed me some light. So keep doing what you're doing. And I was at home when I saw that, and I showed it to my wife, and we got teary, like I'm getting teary right now. That's why. And it is worth it. And it's hard on all of us. It's hard on our families. Bless our wives and our kids who let us go for weeks, and bless the people who trust us with their money. It's because strangers tell us that it saved them from a dark time.
Season 1 to season 2, you see this step up in production value. The most important thing is making sure that we're faithful to the message of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and people are hearing that, and that it's a spiritual benefit to them. It increases their faith in God. It increases their faith in God's Son, in his word, and it's worth it. And it's been amazing to be a part of it.
This has been a 2 year plus adventure. And to say that is a job well done, that we could do what we set out to do. We believe that we've got really exciting things to continue, but that's a job well done. And to God be the glory.